Hello iedereen, welcome by Dutch & Go. Today we're going to talk about separable verbs, and this is the third part in a video series about separable verbs. And I basically want to explain to you another category of separable verbs. Last time we talked about separable verbs in the case of transportation, and today we're going to talk about them in terms of transformation. So, you know, that's kind of easy to remember. Transportation, transformation. If you haven't seen my previous videos on separable verbs yet, I would highly advise you to watch those first, because everything that I'll be saying here in this video will make so much more sense if you do. And now I've said separable verbs way too much already in this introduction. Let's go! So, I'm going to be talking about the last category of separable verbs, the second and major category of separable verbs, basically transformational separable verbs. And by that, I mean these are verbs in which the part is, in which the aspect of transformation is quite central. We have a certain amount of verbs, and with that we'll be able to combine a certain amount of particles. If I said in a previous video participles, I really meant particles. Particles, so little elements that we can put in front of a verb in the infinitive, and that will go in the eindgroep at the end of a sentence, if you remember the first video in which I talked about the structure. So, having said all of that, let's look at some concrete examples and let's look at how these verbs work, because there is a certain logic behind these verbs and it will make your study work so much lighter and easier if you get the hang of it. There we go. So, first of all, let's look at a verb like even gaan. So if you remember, gaan was in the first category of separable verbs. Weggaan, for example, you know, a transportational separable verb, weggaan. But even, for example, this one also behaves in a similar way to transformational separable verbs. By that I mean, for example, mijn moeder gaat weg, which is sort of the concept of not only, you know, transporting, but also the concept of my mom is leaving. It is happening right now. Transformation is happening. And then the result is, afterwards, mijn moeder is weg. So that is the same word. Weggaan, and then weg zijn, to be gone, to go away and to be gone. For that we can use the same word. That makes it so much more easy, and I hope that also just helps you to understand a little bit how these particles work. Also, for example, the same thing, mijn broer komt terug. Resultaat, mijn broer is terug. So basically, some of these separable verbs imply a certain transformation, a certain change, which you can then later on express that the change has happened, that the change is finished with the verb zijn and the same particle of the separable verb. Now, let's look at some verbs that do not belong in the category of transportation, but that exclusively belong in this category. Let's start with a simple verb like maken, and what you can do with maken. Careful, everything that I'm saying here, I'm not saying this is an exhaustive list of separable verbs, I'm just saying that these verbs kind of all make sense in the same category. But this is far from exhaustive, there are some other options too. But let's look at, for example, a verb like maken, and then specifically klaarmaken. So for example, mijn moeder maakt het eten klaar. Resultaat, het eten is klaar. Kapotmaken. De kinderen maken de auto kapot. Resultaat, de auto is kapot. Schoonmaken. Ik maak het appartement schoon. Resultaat, het appartement is schoon. Or you can even combine it with whatever color you want in order to say that you are giving something a certain color, painting something a certain color. So for example, koffie maakt de tanden bruin. Resultaat, de tanden zijn bruin. Or for example, de schilder maakt de kamer wit. Resultaat, de kamer is wit. Let's look at another one. Often confused with maken, doen. For those of you that struggle with the difference between maken and doen, maken is a lot more about constructing something, about, like you would actually use it in English, to make. It doesn't correspond perfectly, but normally when you would use make in English, you could use maken in Dutch. Whereas doen is a lot more related to activities, sports, activities in general. And then there are certain ambiguous situations, right? So for example, you could say, ik maak het huiswerk en ik doe het huiswerk. So, you know, you can use both. But let's look at doen, and let's look at something like, for example, open doen, to open. Ik doe de deur open. Resultaat, de deur is open. Or, for example, ik doe het raam dicht. Close the window. Het raam is dicht. And even another kind of verb that we can make with doen. Aandoen, uitdoen. Aandoen, uitdoen. Aandoen to turn on. Uitdoen to turn off. So basically, this you can use for anything that has a switch and that works with electricity. So, for example, ik doe de radio aan. I turn the radio on. Resultaat, de radio is aan. Or, for example, ik doe de oven uit. Resultaat, de oven is uit. In terms of vocabulary, you can combine these verbs with any words, any kind of appliances, tools, whatever, that have an on and off button. Another verb, for example, is werken. And in here we have afwerken, which is a little bit less transparent than some of the other verbs that we've seen so far, but it kind of means to finish something, right? It's not really related to work, but afwerken means to finish something. So for example, ik werk mijn thesis af. Resultaat, mijn thesis is af. So again, the principle remains the same. Samen, then the final one, rather, is schilderen. Schilderen. So again, schilderen you can combine with whatever color you like. So, for example, wij schilderen de kamer zwart. Want wij zijn gothic. Resultaat, de kamer is zwart. Schilderen to paint, obviously. Alright, so basically, that was the explanation of how this second category of separable verbs work, how separable verbs with the transformation and result work, and how the particle can both be combined with a certain verb and then with the verb zijn. So I hope that that was clear, and I hope that it also helped you to link certain things. In general, it's true that separable verbs oftentimes imply a certain result or finality. Of course, that's not true for all separable verbs, and the two categories that I've given you are some of the most frequent, some of the most common separable verbs that you'll probably need on an A1 level. Of course, as I've also said in my first video, there are many, many, many more. And if you're interested, I'm also happy to make a video about those, but I kind of would say that for those verbs, you really just need to have a dictionary and look up the meaning. I'm thinking about verbs like uitnodigen, which means to invite. Why does that mean to invite? I have really no clue. I mean, etymologically, there's of course a reason, but you know, you can't really derive its meaning looking at the verb. Uitnodigen is not even a verb on its own, right? Voorbereiden, voor, pre, and then bereiden kind of means to prepare, but pre-prepare, that's a little bit less obtrusive, a little bit less difficult to understand. But still, I mean, you know, then you have a lot of separable verbs in various degrees of transparency and clarity in terms of understanding what they mean, and in that case, it's just best to use a dictionary. Final study tip, if you want to study separable verbs and have them on your vocabulary list, just have a little symbol, a little star or something else to indicate, oh yeah, this is a separable verb and I should use it as such. Having said that too, normally, especially if you're A1, A2, it's going to be quite clear when it's a separable verb and when it's not. You know, like that doesn't... Most often I see that students don't use separable verbs enough or don't separate them, but normally you can sort of tell when it's a separable verb just by the particles. That's kind of it. So, thank you so much for watching. I hope it was all clear. Let me know if you have any questions down in the comment box below. For now, I'll say thank you for watching. Take good care of yourself. And tot de volgende keer. Dag!